Ciao, this is Davide Biocchi speaking, and here we are for my weekly intermarket analysis. So let's start from the euro dollar, and as we let's say thought previously, after the fact that the currency, this currency pair went under 1.17, the main target would have been 1.16, and here we are. So what happened when this currency pair arrived at 1.16? That using nails, using teeth, it is trying to remain around this level. So, in case of losing this level, I see, especially under this first arrow and the second one, I see the potential of the double top here. That could mean, in my opinion, the possibility to go down and let's say to 1.10. So this is quite relevant, quite important. So let's see what is going to happen and let's monitor it in the future. That could be really relevant. Well, we know currencies has a big influence on commodities. So let's see what is happening also on the crude oil in the day of the OPEC Plus meeting. So this is a quite important day for the crude oil. So we are back to the price that this market is unable to go above since 2014. So this is quite important. This area around 66.5, this is very important, and we will see what is going to happen. I see and I think that probably what will come out from the OPEC Plus meeting will have an impact in that. So it's not unusual to have a price exactly under a strong resistance, waiting for news, and maybe it can go for a breakout or can come back. So it's quite important to be here right now, and let's see what is going to happen later today. Then let's see also what is going to happen on the gold that was unable to maintain 1765, then came down 1720, and then a reaction again around the same price. So 1765 that now is working as a resistance. So let's see. We have a very strong support at 1680, that more or less is this level down here. And let's see what is going to happen. Mainly, I say this is the trading range, very, let's say, relevant. And 1830 is the upper part here. So 1765 is still working here. And let's see what is going to happen in the next market session again here. So let's see also what is happening in Europe, where we have seen the DAX index, moving again to touch the price of 15,000, and then having a small reaction, climbing back to 15,070. So we are right now around that level. Let's see what is going to happen, but in this moment, the DAX is weaker than the other European indices, especially, for example, the Italian one is stronger than this one. And let's also see what is going to happen on the stock 50 that is again important and that lost again for the second time in few days the 4,100 support. So it was immediately after the previous support here to work. But still, we have a quite important situation. A lot of traders see in 3950 a relevant level, but in my opinion, we have to wait and to see what is going to happen in the market. For what concerning the situation in US, or the US indices, it's very important from my perspective to highlight the fact that we have seen three different minimums here. Okay, so for three times, we have a new minimum. New minimum, okay. One minimum, another minimum, lower one, and another lower one. So, this is quite important to say that now we are in a short-term downtrend. So, it will be very important for the market to offer us a reaction to let us see if something is going to change because the environment that we have seen right now is not so good. In my opinion, we have two legs to justify, let's say, all the big, let's say, uptrend that we have seen here. The first one is that the Federal Reserve injected money in the market. That was to buy bonds generally, or mainly, But you know, if you buy bonds and the yield are going so down, obviously investors are not keen on buying them again. So they try different alternatives. And let's say, due to the fact that for a long time there was no alternative, they bought stocks. Okay, so this is what happened. And this is the first leg for this very long uptrend that we have seen through the last 18 months. On the other side, we have another really good appeal from the stock market that was that during the last 1.5 year reporting seasons, all these big stocks, the growth stocks, they told us they can go through, they can do better and better and better. And they, let's say, renovate this idea. We can do better, we will have better results, and so on. So this was the second leg on which all this uptrend was based on. Okay, this is quite relevant and quite important. And also imagine if we go back to some years ago when Warren Buffett was writing his annual letter to the main shareholders of his company. He was stating that there was a big increase in gains in earnings, and that was because of a law that put taxes down for companies. Okay, so that was very important. And right now we are discussing that maybe taxes can come back for some companies. So this will impact a lot in this. And the community is not so optimistic. I mean, the investors community, obviously, is not so optimistic as it was before. And we are right now entering the reporting season again. So this will be a key factor because we have one leg, the one based on the activity of the central bank injections of liquidity and so on, that with the tapering will, let's say, work less. And on the other side, we can have for the first time maybe some company that will not, let's say, that will not tell the community of investors what they want to know, because they will offer them some different guidance and so on. So that's why I'm worried about the fact that in short term, we can see probably a change in the market moving from an uptrend to at least at a sideway, even if in short term, in short terms we are in a downtrend, in a downtrend here. So it's very clear. Not so far is the situation, let's say, on the Nasdaq itself. For a long time, I told you that growth stocks are my favorite because they can grow faster and they are more dynamic than value stock. But starting from that, obviously they are more depending from this, let's say, potential movement of the yield that immediately went from 1.2, 1.3 to 1.5. That was a jump, okay? What if it will raise again? So they will be worried. So maybe some investors are already selling a little bit that. So this is something that we will have to face in the future as a main problem, and that will impact a lot the stock indices for sure, because it will impact stocks at the end. So it's quite important to have a look at it. Just have to finalize that is very important, in my opinion, to look at two stocks this week. The first one is Google. Google was quite able to offer us, let's say, to offer us a candle here that is telling us that maybe there can be a possibility to change the situation, maybe to try to recover a little in the price. So this is a quite good, interesting candle. Let's see if something is going on to continue this week, starting from today. So the other stock that it is in this quite similar situation is Microsoft. And as we have seen here, this is a bullish engulfing that we have seen on Microsoft. So let's see, because these are two very important stocks in the geography, let's say, in the map of the S&P 500. So let's see what is going to happen. On the other side, we receive news on Facebook, and we will see if they will impact, let's say, in the chart of a stock. I don't know really. Let's see what is going to happen today. So we have some quite interesting charts here, and this is all from my side for this week. Thank you very much for being here. See you next time. Ciao ciao.